want to break barriers, test your limits, learn the tools of security pros, Callie gives you hundreds of hacking and forensics tools, preloaded. Get real experience with cyber defense and offense. Simulate attacks. Find weaknesses before others do. Callie makes you job ready, sharp, and in demand. Protect systems, build skills, and level up your confidence. Every pro started somewhere. Your journey continues or starts now. Before we get started, there are a few requirements. You want speed, you want power, you need Hyper-V Pro or education. To get started, you need to enable Hyper-V feature on. You also need to have VT-X or AMD-V must be on in the BIOS. Now let's download the ISO. Now let's navigate to Callie.org. Now that we're at Callie.org, go ahead and hit the download. We want to get the installer images. Click the installer images, scroll down, download your image, choose where to save it. So I'm going to call this demo. Demo. And I chose to do the ISO instead of the Hyper-V image because the Hyper-V image requires 7-zip to download. Well, I don't have it on my computer and I'm kind of lazy. While this is downloading, an ISO is a digital disk image. It holds all files for installation. Perfect to install an OS or software. You download it, then mount it or burn it. It's your bootable setup on demand. Use it to launch virtual machines. And the ISO makes installation fast and reliable. It takes a couple of minutes for it to download, so I'll be back once it's downloaded. Great, file is downloaded. Go ahead and open your Hyper-V Manager. On the right-hand side, under Actions, go ahead and select New Virtual Machine. Go ahead and click Next. Here you can have the name. Let's say, Callie, November 2025. Okay, select Next. We want to make sure we use Generation 2. Assign to memory. Memory's good. Hit Configure Networking. Make sure you switch it to Default Switch. Select Next. Let's go ahead and put it to 50. Then go ahead and hit Next. On the installation options screen, go ahead and leave it as Install an Operating System Later and hit Next. You can see our virtual machine is set up. Go ahead and right click and hit Settings. In the Settings tab, we want to go ahead and do Security. We want to uncheck Enable Secure Boot. Callie does not sign the bootloader, which causes security checks to fail. So if you leave that set up, you won't get anywhere. Next, we want to go to the SCSI controller. We want to hit DVD drive, add. We want an image file. We're going to browse to our image file. Go ahead and hit apply. Now let's go to our firmware. Take the DVD drive, moving on up. Hit okay. Now, under the server settings, we want to check to make sure that enhanced is checked. And then under the user settings, we also want to validate that enhanced is checked and go ahead and hit OK. You can see our virtual machine is off. We can right click and hit connect. Now click start. Now the graphical GUI interface is up. Go ahead and hit enter to enter the graphical install. Following through the prompts, I'm in English, in the United States, America English. We're going to go through a series of installations and then we'll have some more prompts. And then, you know, I'll sign off. Okay, now we're going to go ahead and put the host name, Callie. I'm going to hit continue. Domain name, I don't have one, so I'm just going to hit continue. User account. This is your username. It is case sensitive, so make sure you remember. Now choose a password. Again, case sensitive. Hit continue. I'm in the Eastern time. And I'm going to hit guided. Continue. All files. Continue. Oh, I do want to write the changes to the disk right here. Continue. We have picked the language. We have chosen the defaults. Very little action is needed from you while it installs, but while you wait, please leave a comment to support my channel, and I'll be back after the setup completes. You've finished the installation. Go ahead and select Continue. Kelly is rebooted. Now let's go ahead and insert your username and password that you just created. Select Log On. Great. The first thing we want to do is update it. So you can either select the terminal box or you can hit Ctrl-Alt-T and pop up the terminal window. Type sudo, which gets you into admin, apt, update, and we also want to update the distro, sudo dist upgrade, and then we want to hit dash y to say yes for all the prompts. So go ahead and type that and then hit enter, and I gotta put my password. Let it run. It takes a few minutes. The update has concluded. Let's go ahead and restart. And if I can't restart using the command, I can always do shut down now. And then hit start. And that's installing Kali Linux. You did it. You installed Kali Linux. Thank you for sticking with me through this video, and I'd like to thank you for watching.